Good evening, happy Wednesday, Maligayang Midweek Service sa inyong lahat. You're watching Walk by Faith, Church of the Nazarene, also known as LA First Filipino Church of the Nazarene. This is your Midweek Service, and for tonight, we will talk about a very significant topic. Why water baptism? What is water baptism? Why is there a need for us? Water baptized. We have 6 learning objectives for tonight. Number one, we will try to define what is water baptism. Number two, ano ba yung purpose ng water baptism? Ba't natin kinagawa ito? Number three, we will talk about yung water baptism as an act of obedience. Number four, water baptism is about public testimony. Number five, it is also a picture of spiritual truth. It's about death, resurrection, and cleansing. Number six, ito importante ito. Kaya tayo, when water baptized, is that we need to understand na receiving Christ is a prelude to water baptism. So, let's carry on, sabi nga. So number one, let's try to define what is water baptism. Alam nyo, summer ngayon, napakainit. 109, 110, my goodness, araw-araw. At napakasarap mag-swimming at maraming simbahan during the old normal. At kinagamit itong pagkakataon na to na magkaroon ng church event and then invite yung mga tao sa beach or sa swimming pool or sa clubhouse. And then isabay na rin yung mga gustong magpa-water baptized. So, maraming tao na na-water baptized na noong bata pa sila. Ang mga Pilipino specifically ay 80% Catholic. And most of us, no, including me, we were baptized when we were babies, parang. And there's nothing wrong with that. Kumbaga, it's technically, yes, it is a water baptism. What I'm trying to say is, sa mga tao na nakilala nila yung Diyos, no, sa later years ng buhay nila, nagkaroon sila ng isip, no, maaaring 7 years old pataas, they accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. Some of them, they experience another kind of a baptism. Now, this time, they are aware kung ano yung ginagawa sa kanila. At they have this acknowledgement that they are publicly declaring that they are for Jesus. So, define muna natin ano yung water baptism. Alam nyo, sabi, ang water baptism daw is a rite of washing with water as a sign of religious purification and consecration. Okay, ang water baptism ay ginagamit ng iba't ibang denomination ng Christian faith. Pwedeng Catholic, pwedeng yung tinatawag ng mga Protestants, pwedeng yung mga tinatawag na iba't ibang denominations pa. Na hindi lamang Christian faith na nag-water baptize. May mga ibang faith din, no? Na not necessarily related sa Christian faith na gumagamit nito. Or gumagawa nito. Other, iba pa nga yung mga tinatawag na cult, no? Kahit yung ibang kulto, gumagawa rin ng water baptism. Na somehow, kasi kung tatanungin mo, it's like a rite of passage. Parang gano'n, no? Meron na akong narinig na interview, sabi niya, ano po ba ang religion mo? Ang religion ko po ay Catholic, no? Pero ako umaatin po sa Jehovah's Witness. Pero every week nasa Jehovah's Witness ako. Pero Catholic pa rin ako kasi hindi pa ako nagpapabaptize doon sa Jehovah's Witness. So, kumbaga, coming from that picture, ma-observe mo na maraming tao ang intindi nila sa baptism. Ito yung naguhudyat na member ka na ng isang group or particularly ng isang religious group or somehow yung iba, baptism. No, baga part ka na ng organization pag nabaptize ka. So, ganun din. Minsan, sa mga fraternity, pagka napindagan na yan, eh, ibig sabihin, napalo or na-hazing, eh, part ka na ng organization. Okay. Somehow, meron siyang may pinagmumulan kasi doon sa original concept ng baptism. Alam niyo, this rite, no, itong practice na to, no, it was practiced frequently, no, matatagpuan natin sa Old Testament. It signified purity or cleansing from sin and devotion to God. So, yun yung parang important, yun yung pinaka-importance na yung kanyang significance. No? Kumbaga, hinuhugasan ang iyong kasalanan at no, you're turning away from your sin after mahugasan and kumbaga, didi-devote mo yung sarili mo para sa Panginoon. Alam niyo, since baptism was first instituted in the Old Testament, many have practiced it as a tradition, yet have not fully understood its significance and meaning. So, ang nangyari, nung sinauna pang panahon, ito ay isang naging tradisyon na lamang. Hindi na naintindihan ng maraming tao, ano bang ibig sabihin talaga ng ikaw ay ma-water baptized? In the New Testament naman, kung titingnan natin, the significance of baptism is, kumbaga, it is seen more clearly. No? Si John the Baptist was sent by God to spread the news of the coming Messiah, yung pinsan ni Jesus. No? Kaya nga meron tayong one bautismo sa Tagalog. Actually, sineselebrate pa nga natin mga Katoliko, mga kapatid natin Katoliko, yung araw ng San Juan tuwing June yan. Eh, no? Pati sa Balayan, Batangas yata. No? Kung saan nagbabasaan yung mga tao. Well, the kids are there for fun and the elders are there for, you know, merrymaking and drinking. But the truth is, a lot of people, ginagawa nila ito. It's a tradition. Imagine mo, pag-araw ng San Juan, naku po. Eh, nung araw, ewan ko lang ngayon, eh sigurado, magdala ka ng extra damit dahil kahit sino ka pa man, papasahin ka nila. At minsan, okay na kung malinis yung tubig, huwag naman sana yung galing sa kanal. At kasi yun yung idea nila na bawal ka mapikon kasi this is a tradition. But the thing is, we get the tradition from the New Testament. Somehow, we need to understand, in life, it's not just about tradition. It's about the meaning of tradition. Ano bang ibig sabihin? John the Baptist was sent by God to spread the news, no? The good news of the coming Messiah na si Jesus Christ. Yun yung reason behind doon. Okay? John was directed, no, by God to baptize those who accepted his message. So, siya yung sabi nga eh, he's clearing the way. Dumating na, padating na yung Messiah. Ang ginawa niya, doon sa mga tao na magpapakita ng kakaibang faith. Kakaibang faith kasi kailangan mo dito kasi you're coming from Judaism, from a tradition na panahon pa ni Moses. So kakaibang faith, those people na exemplifying na maniniwala sa bagong dating. Maniniwala din sa preaching ni John. And if they believe that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior and they accepted Him as their personal Lord and Savior, idip-dip sila baptizo na to submerge ni John doon sa water. Ibig sabihin, they publicly declaring that for Jesus. So, John's baptizing is called a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. So, naniniwala ito, mga Hudyo na ito, o kahit hindi Hudyo, or particularly sa Hudyo, no? Naniniwala sila na, okay, dumating na yung Messiah, and this Messiah is capable of forgiving my sins. So, since capable siya, siya yung Lord, siya yung may authority, bago daw na ako sa kanya, I accept it. So, yun yung significance ng baptism na to. It's a repentance for the forgiveness of sins. Those baptized by John acknowledge their sins and profess their faith that through the coming Messiah, they would be forgiven. No? Sa pamamagitan ni Kristo, sila ay mapapatawad sa mga kasalanan nila. Kasi before, yung kanilang practice is nagsusulog sila, nag-offer sila sa temple para mapatawad yung mga kasalanan nila. Baptism then is significant in that it represents the forgiveness and cleansing from sin that comes through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. So, mas maganda yung pagkaka-explain, mas maganda yung sa New Testament kung paano present yung water baptism, no? Kumpara sa Old Testament. Okay, so ngayon, so dinefine natin anong ibig sabihin ng water baptism. Tingnan naman natin yung purpose nito. Okay, alam niyo, the purpose of baptism, water baptism identifies the believer with the Godhead. Okay? Kasi merong ano, may triune God, di ba? Merong may three forms. So, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Matthew 28:19, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. So, ang kabilang kasi ni Jesus before He ascended to heaven is to make disciples of all nations. Now, declare who Jesus is. But it will not stop there. There should be baptism. Okay? Linawin natin. Kailangan ko bang magpapaptize before I accept Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior? No. Kung inaccept ko si Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior, at hindi ako nagpabaptize agad, or hindi talaga ako nagpabaptize, halimbawa, at namatay ako, safe ba ako? Yes. The answer is yes. Okay, here's the thing. Baptism is the byproduct of salvation. Baptism is gagawin natin kasi it's a public declaration. Baptism is something na ginagawa mo out of your own will. Not because you were pressured by the religious leader, by the priest, by the pastor, by the organization leader, by the, you know, by the father of the bride, by the yung kapitbahay mo, or yung disciple mo. No pressure. It's a personal decision on your part. And, no, as a believer, it is, kumbaga, acknowledging when you baptize, when you're being baptized, it's acknowledging yung Godhead, okay, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Okay, we need to understand that water baptism identifies us, the believer, with Christ, no, in His death, in His burial, and His resurrection. Kumbaga, it's a good picture of dying to yourself, no? And then you will be buried in water and there will be resurrection and it signifies new life. Sabi nga, when you came to Christ, you were circumcised. But not by a physical procedure na kagaya ng ginagawa ng summer two-year program ni Mayor o anong barangay captain. Hindi yun. It was a spiritual procedure. The cutting away of your sinful nature. For you were buried with Christ when you were baptized. No? And with Him, you were raised to a new life because you were trusted the mighty power of God who raised Christ from the dead. Colossians 2:11-12. So, it's a beautiful picture of submersion, death, and then resurrection. Now, you being lifted up, no? From the water and declaring that you are for God. Sabi nga sa Romans 6:4, we were therefore buried with Him through baptism into death in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father. We too, tayo rin, may live a new life. So it's a beautiful picture. So we define water baptism, we try to look at its purpose. Bakit sinabing act of obedience ang water baptism? Okay, water baptism, kanina binanggit ko, it's an act of obedience. Ngayon, medyo palawakin natin. Water baptism is an act of obedience for us believers. It should be preceded by repentance. Okay, you need to understand. Meron ako naging crush doon sa church na yun. Kaso, problema, it's a born-again Christian church. I've been Catholic for my entire life. Okay, ang gagawin ko, kakausapin ko yung pastor. Magpapabaptize ako para maging part ako ng church. That's not the proper way to do it. There must be a born-again experience first. What is born-again experience? It's a repentance. Now, it's asking God for forgiveness. It is acknowledging that you're a sinner. It is acknowledging that, you know, meron kang original sin, meron kang sin na ginawa na personal sins, and then you're surrendering to God and you're accepting Him as your personal Lord and Savior. From then on, you can decide, no, to be baptized in water, to publicly declare that you're for Jesus. Here's the thing. It doesn't mean na you can be part of the church. It doesn't mean na pwede mo nang ligawan yung gusto mo ligawan dun sa church na yan. It's not about yung motibo na ganun. The motive of the heart, it's all about Jesus. It's all about God. You're doing this because of God, not because you were pressured. Okay, bago ko pumasok sa trabaho na to, since sa Christian school, magpapabaptize mo na ako. Oh, naku, I've been a Catholic for all my life. Iglesia ako ni Cristo all my life. Jehovah's Witness ako all my life. Mormons ako all my life. Pero ang crush ko, ang love of my life, ang fiancé ko, ang gusto ko mapangasawa, is a born-again Christian. So, ibalik, papapaptize na ako. It doesn't work that way. It is, you see, repentance, we need to have repentance first. Before maintindihan natin yung water baptism. So, far-fetched pa yan, water baptism. We need to understand first repentance. Okay? When we understand repentance, mas maintindihan natin na, okay, ang water baptism pala is an act of obedience, not an act of showmanship. Okay? Okay, ano ba yung repentance? Ang repentance kasi, it simply means change. Pagbabago. Hindi pa bago-bago, kundi pagbabago. It is turning from our sin and selfishness to serve the Lord. Before, tayo, selfish. Ngayon, selflessness. It means producing our pride, our past, and all of our possessions before the Lord. Before ikaw ang una, before ibang tao ang una. This time, God. It is God, yun ang mauuna. Before, yung crush mo yung una doon sa church yun, God, so maging part ng church yun. No. This time, it's all about God. It is giving the control of our lives over to God. Sabi nga eh, ni Peter. Peter replied, each of you must turn from your sins and turn to God and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. Then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Those who believe that Peter said were baptized and added to the church, about 3,000 in all, Acts 2:38-41. So, saka pa lang sila na add to church. They accepted Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. They said, Lord, I'm a sinner. I want to repent. I want to change my life. Then, they publicly declare that they're for Jesus through water baptism. Sa kapag naging part ng church. Okay, bigyan natin. What are our learning objectives? We defined it in purpose. Pinag-usapan natin. We talked about that it's an act of obedience. Let's talk about na ito naman na isang public testimony. Okay, water baptism is a public testimony. Public means maraming nakakakita. It's like two or more. Okay? The outward confession of an inward experience. Okay, here's the thing. There's something in you. It has been brewing. No, na parang, wow, boom, 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 change. No? For my personal experience, I get to know the Lord for about a year and a half. May nati-disciple sa akin, matin ako ng Bible study, pero sa totoo lang, I don't want to accept Him kasi it will be over for me. No? Pero meron something na, boom, inside myself, hindi ko maintindihan. And then I decided to accept Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I was invited in a town fiesta in Mabini, Batangas, and we were walking doon sa beach, and then pag-usapan namin ng water baptism. There's something in me na nag-click na you need to do it publicly. Kasi it's an outward confession of something na inward experience na matagal na nasa loob mo. Na paano ba? This is not enough. Gawin ko lahat. Parang hindi ko mapapasalamatan ng Diyos pamita ito. Gawin ko lahat, parang kulang palagi. Parang at least, talaga natin kulang. Hindi naman natin mapapantayan yung pagmamahal talaga. Talagang yung benepisyo natin sa Diyos, lahat ng binigay niya, hindi natin kayang suklihan o pantayan. Pero, as an act of obedience, naintindihan ko, I need to publicly declare that Jesus is my Lord. At least dito man lang. No? Maparamdam ko na mahal ko ang Panginoon. Okay, so it's not a requirement for me to enter the kingdom of God. Yes, you would still be saved. But here's the thing. It's an act of obedience. It's an act of worship. It is telling everybody that, hey, I am for Jesus. In baptism, we stand before witnesses confessing our identification with the Lord. So I ask my schoolmates, my friends, lahat sila Christians. Sabi ko, I want to publicly declare, not necessarily sa buong Batangas, but sa inyo. You are like, how many of you here? Like 4 or 5? I want to declare it to you guys publicly. I am for Jesus. Then they baptize me right there and then. Wala na kami mga extra damit. Just boom. For Jesus. Yeah. So, number 5. So, fifth learning objective natin for tonight. Baptism. Water baptism is a picture of spiritual truth. It's a picture of death. It's a picture of resurrection. And it's a picture of cleansing. Water baptism is a picture representing profound spiritual truth, like death. Sabi sa Galatians 2:20, I have been crucified with Christ and I no longer live. But Christ lives in me. Ito yung experience ko eh. That the life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave Himself for me. That's what I experience. And then resurrection. Romans 6, 4-5. We were therefore buried with Him to baptism into death in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too, pati tayo, may live a new life. If we have been united with Him like this in His death, we will certainly also be united with Him in His resurrection. Wow. Sarap pakinggan. In Romans 6, 10-13, let's continue. He died once to defeat sin, and now He lives for the glory of God. So you should consider yourselves dead to sin and able to live for the glory of God through Christ Jesus. Do not let sin control the way you live. Do not give in its lustful desires. Do not let any part of your body become a tool of wickedness to be used by sinning or for sinning. Instead, give yourselves completely to God since you have been given new life. and use your whole body as a tool to do what is right for the glory of God. So there's death, we're submerged, there's resurrection, we're lifted up, and in resurrection, there must be a changed life. There must be a changed heart. Because of what? Because of another spiritual truth. It's about cleansing. Water baptism is cleansing. Sabi sa 1 Peter 3:21, and this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also, not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of good conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. That's the power. Without the resurrection, pag wala yung tinatawag na Resurrection Sunday, yung iba tawag nila ay mas popularly known as Easter Sunday. Alam niyo, without the resurrection of Jesus Christ, Christianity is nothing. Kasi resurrection defied yung death, yung principle ng death. At walang ibang Diyos na nakagawa nun. Pansinin niyo, all other gods remain dead until now. Our God experienced death, no? Because he was in a human form, but he overcame death. Just like cleansing, no? Sabi dito, but you were washed. You were sanctified. You were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. 1 Corinthians 6:11. Washed, cleansed, sanctified, justified. Alam niyo kung bakit? Why there is power in cleansing? Because there was a resurrection. So resurrection is very important. And number 6, ito importante. Again, sinasabi ko kanina, we must receive Christ first. No? Receiving Christ is important bago natin maintindihan yung water baptism. We receive Christ through faith. Kailangan natin manampalataya. Kailangan natin maniwala. Sabi nga sa Biblia, ang faith daw is something that you hope for na hindi mo nakikita, pero alam mo, padating. No? Alam mo, nandyan. So parang hangin, hindi mo nakikita, pero nasisinghot mo. Sabi nga, for by grace you have been saved through faith. Dahil sa grasya ng Panginoon, dahil sa pagmamahal niya. Yung grasya, hindi ka naman karapat-tapat, pero ibibigay niya sa iyo. No? Dahil sa grasya niya, sinagip ka sa pamamagitan din ng pananampalataya mo. This will be on your part. Kailangan manampalataya, kailangan maniwala. Not of yourselves, you were not saved because dahil sa sarili mo. No? It is the gift of God. Regalo ng Diyos that as a result of works, dahil may PhD ka, dahil leader ka, dahil mayaman ka, dahil madami kang nabayaran. It's not about your work. Sa langit, madaming mayaman, madaming mahirap. Madaming middle class, madaming lower class, madaming high class. It's not about kung anong meron ka. Sabi nga dito, not as a result of works, that no one should boast. Kasi grace, if it is a gift, no one should boast. Kasi regalo eh. Paano pag-iibang na hindi naman galing sa'yo? Right? So, we must receive Christ through faith. Ika nga, sa madaling salita, you must be born again. When I was born, I was baptized. It was December 25, Christmas Day. I was born September 6, 2003. So, I'm 17 years old now. I was born September 6, December 25 of that year, 1973. I was baptized sa Cam Emilio Aguinaldo High School sa isang parish church doon sa Quezon City, sa Murphy. And it's not my choice ng parents ko. Am I thankful? Of course, yes. It's a practicing of their faith. I have no debate on that. But here's the thing. After so many years, after almost 2 decades, I get to know the real God, the true God, the one true God, Jesus Christ. And I experience the born-again process na tinatanong ni Nicodemus kay Jesus doon sa Book of John. Sabi ni Jesus, no, sabi ni Nicodemus, paano po ba ako papasok sa kingdom of God? Sabi ni Jesus, he must be born again, not to physical birth, but spiritual birth. There must be changes. And changes is brought about by repentance. Change of heart, change of lifestyle, change of buhay, changes of perspective, no, changes of pananaw, sa dispositions of buhay, sa mga prinsipyo, changes. You must be born again. Sabi nga, sa John 3:1-8, when we receive Christ, we experience a new birth. Pag tinatanong yung mga ibang Kristiyano, tinatawag ng marami na mas kilala sila sa born again yan. No, they're not born again. They are born again Christians. They are Christians who experience the process of being born again. No, pagka in-identify na, kaya na yung mga born again. Okay? Pag tinanong mo yung mga born again na yan, what's your birthday? Tatanungin ka nila, anong gusto mong birthday? Yung physical birthday or spiritual birthday? Kasi meron silang tinatawag na physical birthday, kanilang birthday. Kailangan sila pinanganap. Pero meron yung tinatawag na spiritual birthday kung kailan nila tinanggap si Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. Doon sila na born again. Okay? Let's go now. If we want to receive Christ, we need to understand that it is a personal invitation by Jesus alone. Okay? Sabi ni Jesus sa Revelation 3:20, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him." Dati di ko maintindihan. Pero nung nag-grama na siya, na naintindihan ko na ang ibig sabihin ng Panginoon. Okay, Lord, ang tagal mo na pala kumakatok sa puso ko. Ang tagal ko na nakikinig sa Bible study, ang tagal ko na mati ng church, ang tagal ko na, alam mo yan, nanonood ng mga kung ano-anong preaching. Doon sa pamagitan, ang tagal ko na nakikinig ng mga Christian songs. Sa pamagitan nun, kumakatok ka na pala sa puso ko, and I kept on ignoring it. "And this time, I want to hear your voice, Lord God, and I will open my door. Come and join me and be seated in my heart." That's what I experience. Alam niyo, receiving Christ involves turning to God. No? From self, it is called repentance. And trusting Christ to come into our lives, to forgive our sins, and to make us the kind of people He wants us to be, not the kind of people we want to be. Magkaiba yun. Tandaan nyo, if there's something that you want to be, that is not God's will, that is your will. Okay? Sabi nga, and just to agree intellectually that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that He died on the cross for our sins is not enough. No, it is not. No, it is enough to have an emotional experience at tumulong luha mo, tumulong sipon mo. It's not enough. We receive Jesus Christ by faith and as an act of will. Okay? Ibig sabihin, naiintindihan natin. Ibig sabihin, nag-manifest sa buhay natin. And from then on, nagkaroon na tayo ng relasyon. In-accept na natin siya. We can decide to be baptized in the water and publicly declare that Jesus is a personal Lord and Savior. You're for Jesus. You can go to your pastor. You can go to your cell group leader, life group leader, whoever he is, whoever she is. Pwede siya sa bathtub. Pwede siya sa ilog. Pwede siya sa beach. Pwede siya sa swimming pool. Merong kita ko sa Facebook, mga US Army yata sila. Then, in-accept nila si Jesus na habang nandun sila sa kanilang mission field. And then, nagkumuha sila ng tubig at doon sila nag-water baptize sa freezing cold temperature. So, It's not about the circumstances. It's not about who are the people you're with. It's not about the kind of church, the type of church. It's about your personal decision that you want to publicly declare that you are for Jesus, not because you were pressured by anybody. If you, okay, let's be clear. If you were forced, if you were pushed into. So first water baptism, kahit din pa naiintindihan. I encourage you, do it the second time and this time, gawin mo dahil naiintindihan mo. If you already accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, hindi pa na-experience yung water baptism, I hope this teaching helps you. Na mas naiintindihan mo kung ano to. Go to your pastor, go to your friend na alam mo, spiritually mature. Go to anybody na naiintindihan yung water baptism. It doesn't have to be in the church. Hindi naman kasi kailangan na naka-televise pa, naka-Facebook live pa, whatever. Kasi ang Diyos all-powerful, all-knowing. No? Hindi siya covered ng technology. May sarili siyang technology. He can see your heart. And if you feel like doing it, go. I encourage you. Publicly declare Jesus. And if you want, come to me. Call me. I baptize you myself. I was a speaker sa isang youth camp. Grabe, daan-daan yung umattend. And then on the last day, we tried to explain to them, no, since for the past evenings ng mga services na yun, yung mga evening services ng youth camp, kasi 1 week yun, talagang they're crying out to God, talagang they receive Jesus authentically. And they want to express it and publicly declare Jesus. So we encourage them, here's the beach, publicly declare Jesus. And they all accepted the challenge. And they all said, yes, I want to declare Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Ayun. Na-experience namin. Nagkakulani yata yung kiligili ko, kakatank ng bata. No? Kakabaptize. I don't mind. Nakapagod, pero I don't like, nakababad ka sa tubig for hours. Eh. And then, nakapagod, no? Kasi dami nila. Pero I don't mind. Ang saya ng feeling. Showing, seeing these kids na publicly declaring their lives for Jesus. Their new life for Jesus. So, kung sina-challenge ka ng Panginoon kayo, be baptized. At saka, kung ikaw ay isang leader in church or member in church or worker in church, here's the thing. Observe mo, kapag ang church wala nang na-water baptize for the past months or years, it means it's a manifestation of a church that is probably dead or about to die. Because water baptism is a parang signal that there are newcomers in our faith. So, ibig sabihin doon, marami tayong trabaho na dapat gawin. Maraming explanation. So, I encourage you, be baptized. Accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for tonight. Thank you for explaining us that we need to publicly declare that you are our Lord and Savior. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for the grace. Thank you for the faith. Thank you, Lord God, for this wonderful idea of water baptism to show that we are for you, that you are Lord of our lives. Thank you. You're the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you, guys. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Bye.